We are going to do an experiment to measure three-phase power using two wattmeter method. Experiment number 5. Let us look into the aim. The aim of the experiment is measurement of three-phase power using two wattmeter method during balanced and unbalanced condition. The apparatus required is a three-phase autotransformer ranging from 0 to 600 volts at 50 hertz, one quantity. NAC wattmeter with range 0 to 600 volts, 750 watts. We'll read two wattmeters, an AC voltmeter, 1, an AC ammeter, 1, a few connecting wires. Important thing to note, wattmeter constant is given as current range into voltage range into power factor divided by the full scale deflection of the wattmeter. Let us look at the circuit diagram. We have the three-phase supply coming in to autotransformer. From the autotransformer R phase, we are supposed to connect a wattmeter W1, and from the B phase, we can connect a wattmeter W2. The voltage coils or the potential coils of both the wattmeters are connected to the Y phase of the supply. Also, we have an ammeter in series with the wattmeter 1, a voltage measuring voltmeter across the phases R and Y, and here we have the three-phase, three-wire balance load. The readings we are supposed to take are the voltage in volts, current in amperes, wattmeter 1 reading, wattmeter 2 reading, total power measured by both of the wattmeters. Calculate the power measure on the basis of the voltage and the current readings and power factor. Calculation of power factor using the formula cos phi equals to cos of tan inverse of root 3 times wattmeter 1 reading minus wattmeter 2 reading divided by the sum of wattmeter readings. Looking at the procedure, we have make the connections as per the circuit diagram, keep the three-phase variac at its zero position, switch on the three-phase AC supply, increase the voltage so that all meters give a deflection, note down the readings, bring the variac towards zero position, switch off the supply, calculate the total power measure using the wattmeter readings as well as by calculations. Now let us see how to do the connections. Look at the equipments we are going to make use for the experiment. We have two wattmeters W1, W2, an ammeter, an autotransformer, three-phase autotransformer, a three-phase lamp load. Let us have a look at the wattmeter. The wattmeter has a deflection range from 0 to 1500. Its current rating is 5 ampere bar 10 ampere. Let us look for the wattmeter constant. As we can see here, I can use this wattmeter for different ranges. So if I need a current rating of 10 amperes, I need to join the terminals B1, E2 and E1, B2. If I need for 5 amperes, I need to join B1 and B2. Let us have a look at what is being done in this particular wattmeter case. As we can see, the wattmeter has the connections B1 to B2, E1 and E2 are not connected. So this means that the wattmeter is connected for a range of 5 amperes. Similarly, the wattmeter 2 is also connected for a range of 5 amperes. Let us look at the terminals. This is the common, this is the mains, this is for the load, and these are the terminals for voltages. This is 300 volt and 600 volt respectively. The ammeter which we are going to use is of range 0 to 10 amperes. A few connections have already been made, like we have the R, Y and B supply coming in to the autotransformer at this terminal, and the output is what we are going to use for the three-phase lamp load. This is the lamp load. The input supply is going to be measured using the multimeter which is placed here. Let us start the connections. Wattmeter W1 M terminal, and let us short the MNC terminals together. Next, we'll take the B phase and connect the wattmeter 2 to the B phase. So here is my B phase terminal, and I'm going to short the MNC terminals at the wattmeter. Next, the Y phase. We are going to connect the Y phase to the voltage terminal of wattmeter W1. We'll take another wire from the same terminal and short the wattmeter voltage terminals for wattmeter W1 and W2. Next, the ammeter connections. We are going to connect the L terminal of wattmeter W1 to the ammeter terminals. Here I am connecting it to the 0 terminal of the ammeter. Next, the ammeter has to be connected to the R phase of the load. So here is the R phase terminal. I am going to connect it to the 5 ampere terminal of my ammeter. The Y terminal of the lamp load has to be connected to either of the voltage terminals of the wattmeter. So here I have the voltage terminal of wattmeter W2. I am connecting the Y phase to this terminal. The B phase of the lamp load has to be connected to the L terminal of wattmeter 2. This completes the connections. Next is the conduction. The readings for this particular experiment. The voltmeter has been set for 400 volts. Turning on the lamps, see to it that when you turn on the lamps, the ammeter will show a deflection. The ammeter is showing a deflection of approximately 1.5 amperes. The wattmeters are showing a reading of 280 volts each. Hence, the readings would be 280 watts for both the wattmeters. The wattmeter constant for the currently used wattmeter is calculated as 600 volt, which is the voltage rating, 5 ampere, which is the current rating, 1 is the power factor, 1500 is the total number of deflection. It comes to 2. So each of the wattmeter readings has to be multiplied by the wattmeter constant value, that is 2. The current value is 1.6 amperes. The total of the two wattmeter comes to 1120 watts. Let us take another set of readings.
Here.
Turning on a few more lamps, let us take down another set of reading. Wattmeter 1 shows a reading of 360 watts. Wattmeter 2 also shows a reading of 360 watts. Ammeter shows a reading of 2 amperes. The readings would be 2 amperes, 360 watts into 2, 360 watts into 2, which accounts to 1440 watts. Once the readings are done, turn off all the lamps in each phase one by one. Reduce the auto transformer to 0. Turn off the mains. As the ammeter was showing a reading of 2.05 amperes, I will be changing this value from 2 amperes to 2.05 amperes. Regarding the calculations, the power can be calculated using the formula root 3 times the voltage applied into the current into the power factor. In order to calculate the power factor, we have the formula cos phi equals to cos of tan inverse of root 3 times wattmeter 1 minus wattmeter 2 reading divided by the sum of the wattmeter readings. Now, as both the wattmeter readings are showing me the same value, the numerator is going to be 0 tan inverse 0 is 0, hence cos phi is going to be 1 for both the cases. Next, regarding the calculations for the power, here I have a calculator. So the formula says it is root 3 times voltage into current into power factor. So I have the root 3 value here into the voltage applied is 400 into the resultant current is 1.6 amperes into power factor whose value is 1. The resultant power is 1108.5 for the first set of readings. This is the value of power for the first set of reading. For the second set of readings, we have the same calculation, root 3 into the voltage applied is 400 into resultant current is 2.05 into power factor is 1, which gives me a reading of 1420.28 watts. So 1420.28 watts. This is the experiment on measurement of three phase power using two wattmeter method. We can see that the values of the measured power and the calculated power are nearly the same. Hence, this shows that two wattmeters are sufficient to measure a three phase power.